Welcome to Thungad online classes. In previous videos, we have already discussed what do you mean by speed, what are the types of speed, what do you mean by velocity, what are the types of velocity, right? The first one, what do you mean by speed? The speed means the distance traveled by an object in 1 second. So that is known as the speed. In speed, there are 4 types. The first one is uniform speed. Second one is non-uniform speed. The third one is average speed. And the last one is instantaneous speed. Right? So what do you mean by this instantaneous speed? So instantaneous speed means the speed of a body at a given instant of time. The speed of a body at a given instant of time. So that is known as the instantaneous speed. Okay, see here. So instantaneous speed, that is equal to V is equal to ds by dt. So this formula we have used to find out the instantaneous speed, right? So instantaneous speed means the speed of an object at a given interval of time. So that is known as instantaneous speed. So after that, already we discussed velocity. So what do you mean by velocity? The rate of change of displacement. The rate of change of displacement is called velocity. In velocity, again there are 4 types: uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, average velocity, and last one is instantaneous velocity. Okay, then what do you mean by this instantaneous velocity? So instantaneous velocity means the velocity of an object at a particular instant of time. So that is known as the instantaneous velocity. So here, instantaneous velocity is equal to the rate of change of displacement, that is ds by dt. Okay, so V is equal to, that is ds by dt. So next, in this video, we are going to compare between instantaneous speed and the instantaneous velocity. So the speed is a scalar quantity. It's having only magnitude, but the velocity is a vector quantity. It's having both magnitude and direction. Okay. So in this video, we are going to compare the instantaneous speed and the instantaneous velocity. Okay. The first one. Instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous velocity is always tangentially to the path of the body. Path followed by the body. Okay, see here. So in this case, we are going to consider a plane. This is the xy plane. So this is the origin, that is O. So in this case, we are taking y axis, that is x, and along the x axis, that is time is t, right? So let us assume that a person is standing at the origin and he throw a stone in this direction. So that stone is following in this path, right? So in that case, we are considering the point. So this is a point A, and this is a point B, and this is a point C. So let us assume that this point is A, this point is B, and this point is C. The velocity of the particle at point A, that is V1. The velocity of the particle at point B is V2. The velocity of the particle at point C is V3. So, velocity means it is having both magnitude and direction. Right? So, now if you want to find out what is the direction of the velocity at point A. So, just we are drawing a tangent at this point. This tangent gives the direction of velocity, right? So this here also we are drawing a tangent at point C. It gives the direction of instantaneous velocity. Okay, see. So from this one, the instantaneous velocity is always tangential to the path followed by the body. So this is the path followed by the body, and this is the instantaneous velocity. It is tangential to the path followed by an object. Right? And the next one, second one. An object may have constant instantaneous speed, but variable instantaneous velocity. Okay, see, an object may have constant instantaneous speed, but variable instantaneous velocity. Okay, see, consider a particle which is following a circular path, right? A particle which is following a circular path with a constant speed. So let us remember this is the origin, the textbook, right? So in this case, the particle is performing a circular path with a constant speed. With a constant speed means the speed at any point is same. So let us assume that this is a point A, and this point speed is same. And consider next point, this is B, and this point is C. So here the speed of the particle at point A is also same, at point B is also same, at point C is also same. So that means that particle is performing a circular path with a constant speed. Okay, see. So in this case, we are going to calculate what is the instantaneous velocity. So right. So instantaneous velocity means, so at this point the velocity may be that is v, right? So then the direction of this velocity for this one, we are drawing a tangent at this point. So this tangent gives the direction of the velocity at point A. Similarly at point B, again we are drawing a tangent. So this tangent gives the direction of the velocity. At C point also we are drawing a tangent, that is also gives the direction of velocity. But in this case, the velocity of this particle, the magnitude is same, but the direction of that velocity is different. And each point on the circular path, the direction of the instantaneous velocity is different. So from this one, we are going to do that. An object may have constant instantaneous speed, but variable instantaneous velocity. So here, the path followed by an object in a circular path with a constant speed means the speed at any point is the same. So that means it's having constant instantaneous speed. But the velocity is a vector quantity, it's having both magnitude and direction. So the direction of the direction at point A, the direction at point B, the direction at point C changes. So in this case, the velocity of the particle, the instantaneous velocity of the particle is changes. The third point is the magnitude of instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous velocity is equal to instantaneous speed. Okay. If the magnitude of instantaneous velocity is equal to instantaneous speed, you say the magnitude of instantaneous velocity is equal to instantaneous speed. And the next one, last one. If a particle move with a constant velocity, then average velocity is equal to the instantaneous velocity. This is the fourth point. What is the fourth point here? If a particle moves with a constant velocity, then average velocity is equal to the instantaneous velocity. You see, average velocity that is equal to instantaneous velocity. So these are the comparison of instantaneous speed and instantaneous velocity. Okay, the next topic is acceleration. Acceleration is denoted by small letter a. So then what do you mean by this acceleration? So acceleration means the rate of change of velocity. Then acceleration means rate of change of velocity is called acceleration, right? You see, the acceleration is denoted by a letter, that is a is equal to change in velocity by time taken. Okay. See, the rate of change of velocity means the velocity of an object that it changes with respect to the time. The rate of change of velocity means the velocity of an object that it changes with respect to the time. So then acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time taken. So for example, the change in velocity means that is final velocity minus initial velocity. The final velocity minus initial velocity and time is that is T2 minus T1. So it is written by del of V divided by del of T. So small change in its velocity by small change in its interval. Right? Okay. The next one. What is the SI unit of acceleration? SI unit of acceleration is. See, already we know that the SI unit of velocity is, that is meter per second, and the SI unit of time is, that is second. So then the SI unit becomes meter per second square. Right? The SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. The next one, CGS unit of acceleration is, in SI system, length is measured in terms of meter, in CGS system, length is measured in terms of centimeter, and the time is same, that is second square. In CGS system, the CGS system, the acceleration unit is centimeter per second square. Formula of acceleration. Dimension formula of acceleration is okay. See here. So already we know that the dimension formula for velocity and the dimension formula for time taken. Okay, see here. The dimension formula for velocity is, that is L t to the power is minus 1. L t to the power is minus 1. And the dimension formula for t is time is, that is capital T. So then dimension formula for acceleration is L t to the power t is minus 2. So in this case we are taking t to numerator, so then it becomes t to the power is minus 1. So then dimension formula for acceleration is L t to the power is minus 2. The dimension formula is L t to the power is minus 2, or m to the power is 0, m to the power is 0, L t to the power is minus 2. So this is the dimension formula of acceleration, right? Okay. The next one, acceleration is a vector quantity. It is a vector quantity. It is a vector quantity. So then what do you mean by this vector quantity? So vector quantity means a physical quantity which having both magnitude and direction. So that quantity is known as the vector quantity. For example, a car is moving with a speed of 30 km per hour towards the north, right? So that's the example for vector quantity. So here the acceleration is also a vector quantity. The next one, it may be, so that means acceleration may be positive, it may be positive, it may be negative, and it may be zero. Acceleration may be positive, acceleration may be negative, and acceleration may be zero, right? So this is about the acceleration, right? So acceleration means rate of change of velocity, right? The rate of acceleration meter per second square. The CGS unit is centimeter per second square. Dimension formula is L t to the power is minus 2, or m to the power is 0, L t to the power is minus 2. And next one, it is a vector quantity. So it's a vector quantity means it's having both magnitude and direction. After that, it may be positive, it may be negative, and it may be 0. So then, when it is 0, when it is positive, and when it is negative, right? So here, if an object, the velocity of an object, that is increases with increase in time interval. So then, in that case, the acceleration is positive. So that means the acceleration, the velocity of the body, that is increases with respect to time. So then, the acceleration of that body is positive. So the negative means the velocity of a body decreases with the time interval. The velocity of a body decreases with the time interval. So then, in that case, the acceleration may be negative, and it is also called retardation. It is also called retardation. So retardation means negative acceleration. In negative acceleration, the velocity of an object decreases with respect to the time. So for example, the velocity of an object is more at initial position. After some time, the velocity goes on decreasing with respect to the time. So that is known as the negative acceleration or retardation. Right? The next one, positive acceleration. So positive acceleration means the velocity of an object increases with respect to the time. So for example, the velocity of a body is initially 30 km per hour. So this is 30 km per hour. if the time interval is increases, for example, t is equal to 1 second, if t is equal to 15 second, the velocity of that particle, that is, increases. The velocity of that particle is increases. So, if the time interval is increases, the velocity of that particle is increases. In that case, the acceleration is positive. The acceleration is positive. And the last one is, when the acceleration is zero. When the acceleration is zero. If an object, it is moving with a uniform velocity or constant velocity, in that case, the acceleration becomes zero. See, the constant velocity means, in that case, the velocity at any point is same. So, for example, a particle or this body, it is moving with a uniform velocity means, the velocity at any point is same. For example, t is equal to 1 second, t is equal to 10 second, t is equal to 15 seconds. Right? So, this body with uniform velocity, for example, v is equal to 50 meter per second. 50 meter per second. So, that means the velocity of this particle, that is same, constant. At this point is also its velocity is 50 meter per second. At this point also its velocity is 50 meter per second. So that means the velocity at any point is same, right? So here we are going to calculate what is the acceleration of this body. For example, so this is the initial velocity and this is the final velocity. So initial velocity and final velocity are same. Then v2 value is 50 meter per second, v1 value is also 50 meter per second, then substitute here, that is 50 minus 50 divided by 50 minus 1 second. So this is equal to 0. If a particle or a body, it is moving with a constant velocity, in that case, that body having a 0 acceleration.
The next point, the acceleration vector quantity, that means it's having magnitude and it's having the direction. Then, what is the direction of the acceleration? The direction of acceleration is the direction of a change in velocity. Okay, the direction of acceleration is the direction of the change in velocity, right? This is about the acceleration. So, next one, types of acceleration. Types of acceleration. The first one is uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration. And second one, non-uniform acceleration. Non-uniform acceleration. And third one, average acceleration. Average acceleration. And the last one is instantaneous acceleration. Instantaneous acceleration. Right. So then, what do you mean by this uniform acceleration? So uniform acceleration means if an object is said to be move with a uniform acceleration, if an object is said to be move with a uniform acceleration, if the magnitude and the direction of the acceleration is constant during the motion. So that is known as the uniform acceleration. Okay, see here, an object is said to be moved with a uniform acceleration. Move with a uniform acceleration. Move with a uniform acceleration. If magnitude and direction of acceleration is constant during its motion. So this is the definition of uniform acceleration. So uniform acceleration means an object is said to be moving with a uniform acceleration if magnitude and the direction of the acceleration is constant during its motion. So this is known as the uniform acceleration. Okay, the second one, non-uniform acceleration or variable acceleration, right? So non-uniform acceleration means an object is said to be moving non-uniform acceleration if either of magnitude or direction or both changes during its motion. So that is known as the non-uniform acceleration. So non-uniform acceleration means an object is said to be moving with a non-uniform acceleration if either of magnitude or the direction or both changes during its motion. So the next one, third type. Average acceleration. So it is defined as change in velocity divided by average acceleration. It is defined as change in velocity divided by time taken. So this is known as the average acceleration. The next one, instantaneous acceleration. So already we know that instantaneous velocity means the velocity of a body or an object at a given instant of time. So instantaneous acceleration means the acceleration of an object or a body at a given instant of time. So that is known as the instantaneous acceleration. So instantaneous acceleration, that is A is equal to dv by d. So this gives the instantaneous acceleration. So instantaneous means what is the acceleration of a particle at a given instant of time. So that is known as the instantaneous acceleration. Okay, in today's class we have discussed the comparison of instantaneous speed, instantaneous velocity, so after that acceleration, types of acceleration, right? So in next class we will discuss about position time graph, acceleration time graph and velocity time graph.